My name is Christina Curtis, and I'm faculty at Stanford University. I also serve as director of breast cancer translational research and co-director of the Molecular Tumor Board, and I'm a Chan Zuckerberg BioHub investigator. I think that basic science holds fundamental clues as to how to advance our treatment of cancer, and the basis for many of our discoveries started with a fundamental question about how a tumor begins. Very basic. How does it become what it is, and why does it go on to do what it does next, and when will it metastasize, and when won't it? And so these are really sort of critical questions that have been hard to study using current tools, because we want to do this in the human system. And one of the approaches that we took to this is to use really powerful computational techniques applied to genome sequence data to infer the past proliferative history of a tumor. And I think it was really rewarding to see the kinds of insights that can be gleaned and to do this directly in human samples. But I'm equally, you know, excited about the fact that these discoveries, several of our discoveries around how tumors evolve and how they metastasize, actually afford clinical insights as well, because they tell us that some of the most critical events happen exceedingly early. And while this is early in the history of the tumor, there's actually potentially decades since the initiating hit, since the first mutation. That gives us a real window, a window of opportunity to ask, could we detect, could we intercept earlier? And moreover, can we risk stratify patients who are really at risk of having a lethal tumor versus a more indolent tumor? And so while the discoveries that we've made that are being recognized by this award are very fundamental, they do have translational implications. And I think having gotten into this work because of the motivation to ultimately help patients, that in itself is hugely rewarding. And I really look forward to seeing these discoveries through to achieving that clinical impact. And of course, you know, we know that can take years, but it's a cause that I'm really committed to. I really feel that we're at this inflection point on this sort of vast frontier where we have generated as a community and fueled by really vision that came through the ACR as well, to generate such a vast compendium of molecular information that can now be linked to clinical information, clinical outcomes, even imaging data. And I think that we're just at this tipping point where that information can truly be harnessed, because there's enough of it, because it's well curated enough, and because the computational tools have matured in a way that we can now use that information to better diagnose patients, to better stratify them, and determine what kind of therapies they may benefit from. I decided on this trajectory when I was about 15, and it was really guided by the fact that I had lost several family members to cancer. And I remember learning the very basic fundamentals of cancer genetics in a biology class. And I thought, why don't we know more? And how can we go about sort of unearthing this? What is a malignancy? How did it begin? How did it form? And this was at the time when you know, genetics was still relatively primitive, but there was talk of sequencing human genomes. And I then got involved in a Women in Science program, and I think I saw for the first time, you know, a piece of DNA being run out on a gel, a really simple, trivial experiment by that time, and I was absolutely hooked. ACR is really the bedrock of and a guiding light for cancer research. It helps set the stage and the tone for the most important initiatives and priorities. I think there have been tremendous examples of this, many championed by past presidents, but broad initiatives that have been rolled out through the ACR. And so I think there's such a critical need for training, and I love that part of the ACR's mission is to train the next generation.